Hello everypony, Dale over here. Warning, this video will contain artwork from my DeviantArt, and also warning, it's going to contain my personally stuff. So if you don't like stuff like this, click away or else stay. Yeah, here we go, 3, 2, 1. So this is answers to my Q&A, and I'm so sorry that I actually forgot to answer the questions that I had. Now, I only had like 2 or 3 questions, so it's not going to be this long, but yeah, it's like because I was at exams or re-exams, I passed my test, thank God. So yeah, I have been doing a lot of other stuff, and maybe I have bitten over more than I could actually chew, or how to say that. And I'm also like in internship, so I'm doing my practice every day, trying to do what I can to both write my practice paper and also be on my, you know, stuff on my internship. But okay, without further ado, I will answer the first question, and that is, how did you come up with the rainbow alicorn? Well, the truth is, since I was small, I have always drawn like horses, like alicorns. Now, I know that sounds a little bit weird, but like, I remember my mom actually telling me when I had to draw a horse, or, you know, that she asked to have a horse, I suddenly had the thing with drawing, you know, wings and horn on it. The rainbow wings was actually because I did not feel like I deserved to be an alicorn yet, or deserved to also be able to fly. So that was why I made the rainbow wings, because I thought they were cool looking. I like rainbows, and I was like, well, if it's rainbow wings, I can't fly yet, but I will, you know, eventually learn how to fly. And now I got my nice rainbow wings because I am in love with second opinion. So that is what I'm flying on, you know, the rainbow wings becomes whole when I have a good relationship and I have like love and I have everything. But I don't think it's going to change no matter what. I have now decided how my wings are looking, and you know how my OC is looking, why I did make a alicorn, and I actually feel like I deserve also to be able to fly. So yeah, that is actually all. So that is it for that question. The next one is, I actually wanted to not be compared to any other ponies. I know that there is Lightning Bliss, and she also have stuff with rainbows, but she's the alicorn of rainbows. I am the queen of the rainbow knights. So that is the difference between me and her. Actually, she could also be one of my rainbow knights, but yeah, you putting, you know, you being like it was all Bliss's idea and stuff like that, that is not true. Actually, the rainbow knights, the rainbow wings, and you know, all of this stuff with my OC was long before Lightning Bliss, actually. So that comes to the next question, that is, when did you start your channel, your MLP stuff? And if we take my first MLP video, I will put a link to it in the description below. It was the 22th or the Yeah, the 22th of December 2013, that was my original start. And the 15th of October 2010, I made a spore video. So I don't know which one you are counting, but I'm guessing that it is the, you know, MLP first video start. So I was there like since 2013, so yeah, it's been a while, like, yeah. and in December of all times, where, you know, it's supposed to be Christmas and you have time with your family and stuff, I also made some videos appreciating my family and friends and saying thank you and stuff like that a long time ago. So that comes to my next question, that is, when I got into MLP, and that must be around the you know, timeline of December, maybe a little bit beforehand, because it was actually my ex-boyfriend that introduced me to MLP. Now, he was not a brony himself, but he showed me the show, and I watched the full season one, the first episodes of season one, and I remember seeing Celestia and being like, I want a pony like this. I want like to be a alicorn. I want to be the source of inspiration. I want to be the light in the end of the tunnel, or how to say that. And yeah, that is actually how I you know, started with all of this. So yeah, next question, please. How did you get your cutie mark, or how did you come up with your cutie mark? Well, I had a lot of cutie marks. Like, I had three different kinds of cutie marks. It all started out with this art palette that have actually three colors on, and then five colors on. But I will start with the art palette. The art palette, I thought that, like, everybody had, like, something with an art palette and a pencil or something in those lines. So I wanted to be unique and, you know, branch out from this and stuff like that. And because I actually had a period where I fell in love with music, I changed my cutie mark to be this G-note with colors that comes out of it, and also a pencil again. The pencil have always been there since the start, because it's showing my love for artwork. But then I, you know, one day when I actually was thinking about it, I was thinking about what represents me, what do I want the cutie map or the cutie mark to represent. I wanted to represent hope, I wanted to represent love, and I wanted it to represent artwork. So I took the inspiration from love, hope, and faith, and just switched out the faith with artwork. That is also why the pencil is going up in the sunrise or the sundown or what it is. It's also because, like, it's showing that I am, you know, have a compassion for the new day. That is also why I was, you know, switching my OC name to Daylover instead. I have always been called Daylover. I should not have, you know, started with the Artelisiana. I should have been Daylover since day one. But, like, I have, maybe I have found out that the other one was too hard to pronounce and also too hard to remember. The Day Lover is like also what I represent, because I'm an A person. That is a person that wakes up early in the morning. I love the day. I like do everything in what I can in the day and get the most out of my day, or how to say that. And the representing of the heart is, like, I love my artwork, I love my community, I love my fans, and I love family, friends, and I have so much love to give. And then there is the anchor, that is the sign of hope, because I look into the future and I really hope for getting myself grounded more, and hoping for a better future, getting a job, and I know there's also like water and grass, and I did a little bit of the grass. It's always greener on the other side, so I took the dark grass outside of my heart, and then my OC colors inside of my cutie mark, because I want to be the grass that is always greener on the other side, or how to say that. And the water says itself, because I really like to swim and I love the ocean. I love like sea animals and all of this. I also like normal animals. My favorite animal is actually a wolf. But yeah, I don't know if this answers all of your questions. It was only like one pony that asked me all these questions, but like I am thankful for everything, and I hope that you guys will ask me more questions. I will see what I can do to actually answer more questions if there comes more. And I'm so sorry that it took me this long to actually answer these questions, but yeah, it's just the way it is right now with my practice and school things. The reactions, I don't know. Maybe I will try to see if I have time to make one today, but elsewise, it's going to be like one each day that I have time, or how to say that. And I know that it sucks, but yeah, again, that's just the way it is. Maybe I also want to say to you guys, in September, there's going to be more with me and second opinions, so you can be looking forward for that. I will leave a link to a GoFundMe that second opinion actually made, so he can, not that he's not coming, he's coming to Denmark, but he needs like the economic stabilized stuff, or how to say that. So I hope that you guys will check that out, and that is actually all. Yeah, okay. Do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and your loved ones. And that was actually all. Yeah, okay. Bye.